What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Have my gunners on because I was doing some gaming. You have to wear gunners if you want to game. Are these still around? Anyway, today I want to tell you guys 5 things that you should be doing when you're unemployed. Now, I know being unemployed can be very frustrating, and the first thing you want to do is to just find another job immediately. Now, I actually think it's a good thing to actually take some time before you jump into a new position or a new job. It's very easy to get caught up in the grind and the need to find a job right afterwards because you're worried about all of these other things. In most situations, a couple of weeks off, it's not really going to make or break your lifestyle or your life. Unless it does, and then you gotta, you know. But if you're in a situation where you cannot really afford to take a week off, you have to jump into the next job in order to put food on the table, then of course this doesn't fully apply to you. But I think most of us in our situations, we're so deep in the idea that we always have to be employed for us to find any success in life. So here are 5 things I think you should be doing when you're unemployed, and these are typically the things I would do when I'm moving between jobs. The first thing you should be doing when you're unemployed is that you should get your fitness and your health in a better position. You have no more excuse of you have no time, you have to go to work every single day, and on weekends you're too tired to do this and that. Now you have all the time in every single day, so there's no excuse for you not to crack down on your diet. There's no excuse for you not to go out and exercise and move around more. Studies have shown that if you're more physically healthy, you actually become happier. Being able to have some type of happiness and positive feedback for yourself, it's very important. And also, it's just gonna be healthier, and that's always gonna be a good thing. So if you're in between jobs right now, you should be working out. You're not trying to be a professional athlete, but you should be at least doing some running, doing some weightlifting, doing some calisthenics, doing some yoga. One of the hardest workouts is just yoga. If you've never done it, you have no idea. So go do something. Get your diet together. Start eating some vegetables, everyone. Oh my gosh, start eating some vegetables. Don't go vegan, but start eating some vegetables and start being a little bit more active with your life. The next thing I would urge all of you to do is to start reading. Most of you are probably like me. You haven't read a book since, I don't know, the 10th grade in high school when you were forced to read Lord of the Flies. Poor Piggy. Anyway, start reading some books. If there's always been a field that you're curious about, or even just a field that you're into, if you're really into working out and fitness now that you don't have a job, maybe look into more of fitness and nutrition. Or if you want to go more in depth into a new field, if you're curious about marketing and data analysis, you can find some books and information around that. If you're planning on starting a family, if you want to change the way you dress, there are a lot of things that you can read up and study on. And I think it's always good to read into something that you may potentially disagree with, because you never know what you're going to find out. So start reading, everyone, whatever book you guys want to read. The third thing that I will urge all of you to do is look into doing some hobbies. It doesn't have to be a very productive hobby. You don't have to go and try to become, I don't know, a motivational speaker or anything like that. You don't have to go out there and try to change people's minds, but something you're into. If you like to fly kites, just go out there after your workout. Maybe it could be part of your workout. Go to the park and fly some kite for a couple hours. Or if you always wanted to learn how to do carpentry and put together bookshelf or desk drawer, look into opportunities of doing that around you. If you wanted to get better at cooking, maybe there's a perfect opportunity to combine this hobby with bettering your nutrition. Learn how to make all those nasty vegetables taste better. The answer is butter. So pick up a hobby, keep yourself occupied but in a positive way. So start reading some books, exercising, eating better, doing something that you're passionate about where you're not focused on making a paycheck every single week or every single month. Now the fourth thing I would recommend, doing something to help improve your mindset. What I mean by that, a lot of people will urge you to do some meditation, but you don't have to meditate and sit there quietly. I can't do it. It bugs the crap out of me. Maybe that's something I should start working on, because I do hear a lot of benefits to meditation. What I mean is, this is a perfect time for you to start reflecting on your life and the choices that you've made. Now, I don't mean to be filling your life with regret, but just start thinking about the way you make decisions and why you make those decisions. Perhaps there are gaps in there where you feel like you can improve on, and maybe those improvements that you need can be tied into the hobbies that you pick up to help better your life. So when you move forward in a new job or a new career path, wherever it is you're going, you go in there with a better mindset and putting yourself in a much better place than you were before. Always look to improve yourself. I know sometimes when you're actually working full time, you may find it difficult or have the time to really sit down and think about your life and yourself. And so right now, this is the perfect time to look for ways to improve yourself, your mindset, your mentality. And last but not least, The fifth tip I have for all of you who are unemployed and going through jobs, transitions, is just relax. Relax, rest, recenter yourself, you know, go through all of these other things, start reading books, exercising, just doing things to kind of enjoy the moment. Every single day, we're always working, we're always trying to get that paycheck because we have to pay for this, pay for that, gotta buy this and buy that. And half the stuff we buy isn't even necessary. It's just to show people that, hey, I have a job and I'm working. Okay, don't judge me. But how often do we actually get to kind of sit down and start doing things that we actually care about, that we want, that can improve us mentally and physically, and not be focused on trying to make that paycheck and be frustrated all the time because we're never making enough. But we're still preoccupied with always making that money, trying to make more money so that we can buy all of these stuff that we probably don't even need. And we never take the time to actually sit down, lay down, whatever, to think about ourselves. What should we be eating? How often should I be exercising? What type of exercises do I like? What are my hobbies? Remember when we all had hobbies growing up as a kid? We all pretended to be something. What happened to those dreams? And now's a perfect time to look into some more hobbies because time is kind of what we have, right? Now we have time, maybe we should spend that time on ourselves. Those of you who are unemployed and transitioning through new jobs and new career paths, I hope this can be a little bit helpful for you guys. Don't feel down and pressed every single day. I'm sure you will on some days. It hits us all, right? It's not the norm. The normal thing is to work all the time and we're not working right now. But channel that energy to improve yourself in ways that you weren't able to or didn't think about doing when you had the job. And now that you don't, this is a perfect time to make yourself a better person. So have a great one, everyone, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace.